In this video, I want to show you how to successfully apply online for the Karta Krakowska, and if you don't know what that is, watch my other video to know more about it. And if you already registered but it seems that it's not working, write the comment below this video, let me know more about the problem you are facing, and will do my best to help you with it. Before we start, make sure you have all needed documents in electronic form, such as a current photo, and also first page of your PIT-37 tax form, and the acknowledgement of receipt of the PIT, UPO. Got it?
That's great, you can start to apply.
So first you need to open your browser and enter the address www.kk.krakow.pl. If you already registered here, you can skip this part and start from next point where we will be filling and submitting the application.
Otherwise,
click on the yellow button in the upper right corner, Registrazia, Register. In the Dana Oso Porva, Personal Data, enter your first name in the first field, last name in the field below it, and then your PESEL number. Then provide the email address with which you want to register and repeat the same email. As for the password, it must have at least 8 characters, one uppercase letter, one number, and one special character. Repeat the same password and click on the Zapish button at the bottom of the page.
Now, we need to check our email and click on the activation link. Received email should come within few seconds, and should look like that.
After successful activation, we need to click on the blue button in the upper right corner that says Logo Ani, Login. Log in with the data provided during the registration process.
Right after logging in, you should see such a view.
We have the Vitae, first and last name panel, which includes the Zwosh Vnioshik, submit application option, among others.
Click. Part of the data is already completed with the data provided during registration.
First checkbox, in our case, we do not select it.
This is an option for Krakow residents registered for permanent residence. We proceed further and complete the correspondence address data.
The city, it does not have to be Krakow, it should be the address to which the plastic version of the Karta Krakowska status carrier will be sent. Then provide the name of the street, building apartment number, postal code, and finally the telephone number. It is worth checking this box if we plan to purchase a periodic ticket for public transport with a special discount using the selected Karta Krakowska status carrier. Karta Krakowska can be confusing.
This will save us a trip to the Krakow City ticket sales point. Now we need to decide in what form we want our card.
We can choose the mobile form, MKK, or the plastic form, KK, or both. Select a profile photo, which is required to properly complete the application.
This section is grayed out.
As we mentioned in our other video discussing the Krakow card, the carriers of the Krakow card status can be very different.
Here I'm listing them again as reminder. So here in this grayed out section that allows us this multiple options.
But since we selected both the mobile form MKK and the plastic form KK earlier, we don't need to select anything here.
There is also an option add a child in our application, but for the purposes of this video, we will skip this step. Now click on Vizli Vyosek, submit application.
We see some additional control information asking us if we are sure we don't have a permanent residence registration and the information that we can add our child's data to the form, because if we don't, we will have to personally submit such an application in paper form at a ticket sales point.
We need to click Vizli Vyosek, submit application again. The message here is saying that our application has been accepted and is awaiting verification. Let's stop here for a second.
I don't know if you noticed, but at the beginning of this video it was mentioned that we would need the first page of the PIT-37 and the UPO. But so far, there has been no possibility to attach them. Here, we are informed that we should now go to any ticket sales point of MPK SA and Krakow to show these documents.
So it might look like the process is not 100% online. But in the meantime, we should receive an email that looks something like this.
The email says that we can indeed bring these documents to those ticket sales points, but we can also deliver them by email to the address okaspit@kk.krakow.pl. Send the email to that email address, and attach first page of PIT-37 and UPO. After few days you should get email, confirming your application being successfully verified. I got such an email after 3 days. Now, Just download MKK application either from Play Store or App Store, log in with data provided during registration.
And that should be it. If that didn't work for you, leave a comment with information what went wrong. And we'll try to help.